Hello everyone, welcome to First Impressions Friday. It's great to be back. We are going to be doing a feature on an app called Session. This is more of an advanced Pomodoro application. We're going to be giving you opinions and thoughts on how it works and also just a little bit of a rundown of the application. So today's video is sponsored by Woven. Here's a little bit more about them.
So this month's sponsor is Woven. It is great to have them back as a sponsor. If you don't know what Woven is, it's a powerful calendar and scheduling application. It's actually my go-to calendar application and helps me schedule the majority of my meeting. Features include the likes of scheduling tools to be able to organize those meetings, whether they're group ones or individual, multi-calendar support, video conferencing for connecting apps like Zoom, and templates for saving you time with those routine meetings. You can get Woven for free in the description below and check out more. A huge thanks to Woven for coming on as a sponsor.
So this application Session is essentially available on Mac, iPhone, and also through Set app, which I'll show a little bit later. Set app is like sort of like a Netflix for Mac applications, allowing you to get a range of them. And the developer is called Philip Young Gunawan, I believe, again, pronunciation. And this application is currently getting some good opinions on it. As I said, it's more of an advanced Pomodoro tracker, but it's got this also on Mac, this built-in sort of blocker, so you can not go on websites. But it is crazy the level of detail that they've built into this application, allowing you to add notes, daily reviews, and also track your Pomodoros. It is crazy. So let's go ahead and check it out. So as I mentioned, if you are someone that has Set app, you can get this one for free using the app. Obviously you're paying, I think it's $9.99 or $14.99 per month for it. But again, you can see here that I've got this available automatically. You can find a link to Set app in the description below if you want to check it out. So here it is. Here is the famed application Session. Now, what I quite like about it straight away is that it's designed super clean. The logo on iOS and on this looks stunning. It really easy design on the eyes. What you can do here is you can start a session for a specific amount of time, and it gives you a bit of an indication of what time that will take you up to, which is quite cool. Just a small detail that some Pomodoro applications don't tend to include. So you can start the session here, or you can block in one for the future, I believe. No, you can't block in one for the future. You can see how it affects your day. So if I wanted to take myself up to 12 o'clock doing a Pomo session, and I can set an intention up here. So let's add that now. So as you can see here, you've got a little bit of a menu here. If I press start session, that Pomo begins and you can do a little sort of breathe in. I've got a cold at the moment. It's like, so you can start that session. I don't know whether you can hear this, but you've got a really nice like sort of background clock. I quite like that. A timer sometimes is nice to have. Some people might find that too pressurizing. But what can you do whilst you're in a session? So you can have an auto break, so you can start the breaks automatically if you want to. I think you can pause it if you want a break. And you can make notes on anything that are around this. So you could say like, oh, I was procrastinating, or I found this a struggle to record. And you can even finish the session if you want to. There was also the background noise. You can remove that if you did want to. It's too disruptive. You can abandon the session or you can continue with it, but it sort of gives you a hard bit of knowledge about what will happen. You can start to see here that, you know, if I were to complete that session, you can see that I would get sort of a bit of a rating up here. So it would tell me how much time I focused on, how many Pomos I've done today. But you can also see, once you've done one, a pretty deep analysis of your month and how you did it. So as you can see here, you can see what morning ones, what evening ones you did, and how your day looked in terms of how focused you were. I believe you can give yourself a rating afterwards, but you can add one manually if you did want to, and how you felt during it, as well as give yourself some notes. So let's see what that looks like. If I did it for, say, this morning, at about 9:05 to, and I say this was for briefs, not the pants. I was neutral at that session, briefs for editing. So you can see here that briefs come up here and it pops open as a nice sort of outlook. You can see here that if I go to today, I've done 25 minutes of focus time so far. And if you go to today, you can see that on this nice view, it comes up that you've got 25 minute session that's been done. So down here, obviously you can go to your profile and start a registered session. However, you don't actually get that. If you don't want to sync between devices, that's not a default, which is quite cool. You can also see what you need to do in terms of tutorials. You can integrate it with your calendar, which could be quite cool in terms of logging. And up here, you've got a pretty advanced sort of setup in terms of like how you want to customize keyboard shortcuts, times, calendars, you know, the volume, the background noise, and what you can actually see during that session. The website blocker as well, you can set up to enable it and set up what you would like to block. You've also got an app blocker and a Slack blocker too, and if you're really advanced, an automation through Apple Script. So this is probably the best looking Pomodoro application I've seen in years. It is beautiful design. It limits you to Mac and iOS, of course, which is something that a lot of Windows people won't like. However, the design is gorgeous. It works very well, and the data gives you quite a lot of insight into how your productivity has gone for the day. It's not a mood tracker per se. It's not a real sort of deep application. It's more for deep work. It's more to help you get focused. And I definitely might look at this application as one to keep me working on an intention for the day. So definitely worth checking it out. SetApp, it's available through, or you can buy it separately. I actually didn't see a price for this application. Let me double check. So here we go. So I don't know what that price would be. No, it can't be right. It's not less than, it's not 2p for a yearly subscription. I'm going to find out on the price, guys, and probably post it below. I'm not sure why it's coming up in that sort of setup, but as you can imagine, I wouldn't think it would be too bad price-wise. Obviously, setup is probably a good sort of bet. It's going to be $10 a month, but for the whole setup subscription, so I can't imagine it'd be past, say, like $5 to $7 a month, but I'm going to double-check in the description because I'm not sure I've got that right. Okay, guys, hopefully you found that overview useful. Obviously, I didn't go into the blocking side of stuff, but it blocks on all major platforms, apparently. And it's a very simple blocker. Just shows you on screen you aren't allowed on this and that you're in a session. So hopefully that was useful. It's a Pomodoro timer that I will be checking out, and I'm giving it a solid 8.2. out of 10. It's definitely one that has got my attention, and it's probably the most advanced one I've ever seen. But hopefully that was a good overview. Make sure to subscribe, and I will talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.